Well, we're back with another 2 Minute Tuesday. I'm Carlson from Sertus, and this week our topic is what is smoke ventilation servicing and maintenance? It's a question we get asked a lot across the construction and property maintenance industries, and indeed by residents themselves. However, whilst I really hope you find this video helpful, I just want to make clear that this shouldn't stop you from reading the guidance and the legislation. I'll put helpful links wherever I can to guide you in the right place. In the meantime, enjoy the video. First things first, a weekly inspection of the system needs to be undertaken by a named and suitably trained member of the premises management team. According to BS 9999 2008 Annex V, that involves setting the fan sets running, running up any powered exhaust ventilators, checking that smoke dampers open and or close, and that natural ventilators work too. You'll also need to make sure the automatic smoke curtains fall into place, etc. Don't let it stop there though, the whole system does need checking over every single week to make sure it all works properly. Every 3 months, you'll need to check the actuation of all smoke control systems. You'll need to carry out a simulated trigger to the system and make sure each zone works independently. Again, you'll need to make sure that any fans or powered exhaust ventilators work properly and that natural ventilators open too. You'll also need to make sure that the smoke dampers open or close depending on the system. As part of these checks, you'll need to make sure of the following. First of all, the correct cause and effect logic for the system functions as required, and that the system responds to any planned method of initiation, e.g. smoke detectors. Next, you'll need to check that when the primary power supply drops out, that the secondary power supply responds within the interruption time detailed in EN12101-10. Third, check that when any duty equipment fails, that the standby equipment takes over correctly, for example duty or standby fans in a powered fan set. As a fourth, make sure that any system batteries are still within the manufacturer life cycle. The labels should be visible in the ordinary position of the battery. Finally, make sure that all fault monitoring systems work correctly by simulating the fault conditions. On a yearly basis, tests need to be arranged for annual inspections. These need to be carried out by a competent person. Defects must be logged and the necessary actions taken and recorded. A certificate of testing and maintenance should be obtained. There's a complete list of what needs attention in BS 9999-2008 Annex 5. This periodic inspection and maintenance needs to be carried out to check for any unmonitored faults, take preventative action, and ensures the continued reliability of the system. It's also important to make sure the user's aware of any changes to the building which may affect the protection that the system was designed to give. Maintenance must be carried out by a competent person with specialist knowledge of smoke control. They must have adequate access to spares and sufficient information about the system. Competency is a difficult thing to measure, however, it's recommended by guidance that a third-party certification will assure competence. An example of that is IFC SDI 19. There are some key points to be aware of. When maintenance is carried out by a third party, an engineer must be able to attend the premises within 24 hours of a call from the user. There are certain provisions for offshore islands, if that applies to you. The name and telephone number of the persons responsible for the maintenance of the smoke control system must be in a prominent place near the main control panel, and the records and documentation must be kept updated. Finally, the user must record all faults and damages in the logbook and ensure that repairs are carried out as soon as possible. That's an overview of servicing and maintenance for smoke control systems. It's a little bit longer than 2 minutes, so I'm sorry about that, but hopefully it gave you enough in-depth information to be able to at least get an idea of what's required in the servicing and maintenance of smoke control systems. Thanks for watching, have a great week, and I'll see you soon.